Recently, two Duxbury residents made a large land donation to Bridgewater State University. The land, which is in the Plymouth Industrial Park, used to be home to Bartlett Nuclear. PCN traveled over to Bridgewater State to learn more about this generous donation.
Plymouth is hardly a college town, but Plymouth is also no stranger to post-secondary education. Several colleges have a campus of sorts in America's hometown. And soon, you'll be able to add Bridgewater State University to the list, thanks to two former graduates and longtime South Shore residents, Bruce and Patricia Bartlett.
Bruce graduated in 1968, Pat in 67. They met here at Bridgewater State, and it was a love affair. And ever since they've left, they've stayed connected to the university.
President Fred Clark said the Bartletts had already given the university $5 million, some of which goes towards student scholarships, when he received the call about the land donation.
Bruce called me up, and I'm president at this point, and said, you know, I have this property, 25 acres in Plymouth, and I'm thinking, I was going to sell it, and I thought, you know what, I should probably just give it to you. Those are the kind of calls you want to get every day as a president of a university.
The Bartletts, who live in Duxbury, started their business in the Plymouth Industrial Park.
And Bruce started a nuclear training company and wound up training the workforce for most of the nuclear power plants in the United States, and many of them are from around the world. Built up a big business before he ultimately sold it and moved on to other great business adventures.
In a joint statement to Bridgewater State, the Bartlett said, the bottom line is simple. Public education needs private philanthropy, and this is an important time for people to help in any way they can. Higher education opens doors and provides opportunities, and we want those doors open at all times.
This is the largest gift in the history of Massachusetts, certainly the largest gift in Bridgewater's history. Because it's land, it's a little bit different in terms of how we receive it. Now we're going through a process of trying to figure out within our mission what to use the land and the buildings for, and the uses will be consistent with the mission of the institution. So the actual donation goes to our foundation, which is a 501c3 foundation. That's totally tax deductible, so it's an entity that's formed to help the university, but they actually will be the landlords, the owners of the property.
According to President Clark, the land can accommodate future buildings. Currently, there are two colonial office buildings, and one has a warehouse attached.
So what we're thinking about at this point, and we're still early in the process, is to do something in the area of civics education, something in the area of maybe the training of teachers in history, in partnership with potentially Plymouth Plantation, the Pilgrim Museum, other stakeholders in the Plymouth area. We're also thinking about business logistics, and we're talking actually even now to corporate partners where we could do training for our students on the movement of goods. So logistics, civics, history would really make great sense for that industrial park. But we have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of students here that are from Plymouth and in the Plymouth area, and we have thousands of alums that are in that area too. We have a very, very strong partnership with the Plymouth Public Schools, with Plymouth Business. I'm actually honorary chair of the Plymouth 400 organization, and we're working to make sure that Plymouth is appropriately celebrated in 2020. So we are of and involved with and partners with Plymouth already, and I think there's just much more we can do if we're physically a little bit closer.
Reporting in Bridgewater for PAC TV Community News, I'm Walter Cicchetti.